Hello students, today we are going to see another practical, that is to find out the permeability using current balance. Okay, so this is the arrangement of it. Now let me show you that what basically we are going to do is we will try to use the basic fundamentals of the flow of current. Suppose if you have current I1 flowing in this direction, current I2 flowing in this direction and current I1 flowing in this direction, then there will be a magnetic field generation over here, and if the current are in opposite direction, then magnetic field will repel each other. Okay, magnetic field will repel each other, these two rods. Okay, so this is the basic fundamental using which we will find out the permeability of a air. Okay, okay, now let me show you our arrangement. This is you can see there are two bars, okay, two bars just residing on each other, but you can see a space in between. So actually they are separated from each other. They are parallel bars. These are parallel bars separated from each other, and we are going to pass current in both the bars, both these wires, open wires, in opposite direction. Okay, in opposite direction. So this is kind of a simple pendulum, pendulum which is balancing on this edges. You can see this edge, you can see this edge, it is balancing on this edge, it is balancing on this edge. Okay, I have made the arrangement previously. You have to adjust these weights so that it will balance, it will try to balance in its equilibrium condition. Okay, now as it will be very hard to find out the oscillation between these two wires, what we have done is we have a mirror, and an LED laser is pointing on the mirror. You can see it, LED laser is pointing on a mirror. This is the LED spot, and that spot is reflecting on the scale. That spot is reflecting on the scale on the another side. Okay, so let me show you the arrangement. Okay, so this is the LED source. It is going to hit on this mirror, and mirror is reflecting back again on this scale. Okay, so this is our arrangement, right? So that we can see that this bar will move as the current will flow, because magnetic fields will try to repel each other as we are going to pass the current in the opposite direction. Upper one loop is going to pass current in this direction, the lower loop is going to pass current in the opposite direction. Okay, so let me show you the circuit. This is the positive, this is negative. Remember, this is a 0 to 30 volts DC regulated supply, so you have to be very careful to use this supply, because you can see the voltage and the current capacity is 20 ampere. Okay, we are going to use a very high value of current in this, so it is advisable to take precautions in handling this device. Okay, so that's why I have disconnected it before connecting, making on. Let us see the connections. This wire is connected to this point, and this is connected to the upper rod as by this balance, and upper rod is going to have a current flow in this direction. Current will be flowing in this direction, this direction, this direction, then it will move in this direction. Then with this edge, you will have similar edge on that side also, and it is going to connected by this black wire is connected to the multimeter. Okay, because we want to find out the how much amount of current is flowing inside this circuit. Okay, and then again it has been connected to the lower loop. Now you see in the upper loop, we have seen it is going, current is moving in this direction. Now in the lower loop, current is moving in this direction. So both the currents are in opposite direction. It is moving in this direction. Okay, and again from the another side, that black terminal will try to connect it, and black terminal, this wire is going to be connected to this device. Okay, now before going to connect this, let me show you some of the measurements which you have to take. Okay, which you have to consider before going for this practical. those are this list of the observations. Okay, you have to find out the mirror to scale distance, that is 2.3 meter. This is the given, but actually you have to find out, I will show you that you can find out using this scale. Okay, from this this point to the mirror. Okay, to the mirror one. So this is to the mirror one, to the mirror. Okay, so actually you have to find out practically by this, okay, with the help of this scale. That is the mirror to scale distance. Then radius of bar is given 3 mm, that you have to take it. Length of the lever arm is given, length of the upper bar is also given. Scale reading at the time of contact and scale reading at equilibrium. Now these two are very important, okay. Now you can see that both the bars are actually at equilibrium, right? Both the bars are actually at equilibrium. So at equilibrium you are finding that the LED is pointing at near about 4.3, okay. So the scale reading at time of contact will be 4.3. Now to connect these two bars, what I will do is, to connect these two bars, I will put some weight. Now it has been contacted, now it is in contact, and you can see when it is in contact, actually the readings go down because it is getting deflected. Okay, so this is nothing but your scale reading at equilibrium, scale reading at time of contact, and before it was at equilibrium. Okay, now you can see moment I will release this, this will try to oscillate. This is oscillating. Okay, this will try to oscillate. This is oscillating. Okay, and you can see that the beam is also oscillating. Okay, when it comes back again to its equilibrium position, that will be your scale reading at equilibrium. When both the are in contact, both loops are in contact, then the deflection reading, the centimeter reading, that is actually the scale reading at time of contact, that is D1. And when it comes to rest, when this both will comes to rest, this will be at a fixed point, and that is nothing but the scale reading at equilibrium. Okay, now let us clarify more the length of the lever arm A and length of upper arm L. That is already it has been given, but let us specify that what is small a and capital L. Okay, small a is nothing but the length of this arm. This capital L is nothing but the length of this arm. This is the mirror, this is the scale, and this is the laser. Okay, so you can think of it. Okay, this is capital L and this is small a. Okay, these readings are already given. This radius of bar, you have to take it as it is. This mirror to scale distance, you have to measure. This you have to take it as it is. A and L you have to take as it is. This D1, D2 you have to measure and find out the D. Okay, so this is all about the initial part. Okay, now later on you have to find out this this values. Okay, what you have to do is, let me connect this supply. Okay, now when this bar is going to come at its rest position, it will be hard to find out by this, but we can easily find out from the deflection of the mirror of LED that still it is vibrating. Okay, so the moment it will come to its rest position, okay, the moment it will going to come its rest position, it will be near about 4.3. okay, now you can see it is vibrating near about 4, but what we are interested is, now what we will do is, we will take 10 mg, 20 mg. In practice they have taken 50 mg, 100 mg and 150 mg, but we are taking over here 10 mg. This is 10 mg, this is 20 mg and this is 50 mg, okay? So let us keep a 20 mg or 10 mg on this part, okay? The moment we will place it, what is going to happen is, it's going to down, this is going to down, yes, this is going to down to its equilibrium value, okay? This will go down to its equilibrium वैल्यू. इक्विलिब्रियम से वो नीचे चला जाएगा. यहाँ पे इक्विलिब्रियम था 4.3 बट इट विल गो डाउन नियर अबाउट समथिंग 3.8. ओके, नियर अबाउट इट विल गो अबाउट 3.8. ओके, आई विल अलाउ दिस टू कम टू रेस्ट. ओके, नाउ यू कैन सी दैट इट हैज ऑलमोस्ट बिकम स्टेबल. ओके, द ऑसिलेशंस हैज ऑलमोस्ट बिकम स्टेबल. ओके, सो इट इज freely residing. Okay, now what I will do is I will make this on and I will try to increase the current. I will try to increase the current in such a way that I will get the deflection in that point. Okay, I will get deflection in that point. Okay, I will get deflection, upper deflection in that point, and I will pass some amount of current in both these loops. Upper loop will have current flow in this direction, lower loop will have current flow in this direction, and I will pass the amount of current in such a way that this point comes back to 4.3, that this point comes back to its original position 4.3. okay, now let me switch on this to be remembered very careful. Yes, now I'm increasing the current. It's a 5 ampere, 6 ampere. You can see what will be the current. You can see 4.5 ampere current, DC current is flowing in this circuit, and you can see the point is going upward. You can see point is going upward. Okay, again I will increase some amount of current. Okay, and that is 8 ampere from the supply, but actual current flowing in the circuit is 5.6 ampere DC current. Okay, and you can see that point has raised up to 4.3 value. Okay, so this is how we will apply the amount of current in such a way that this will come to its, after putting this weight. Okay, so correspondingly we can also do that, we can interchange this supplies so that this direction current will be flowing in this direction, the downward direction current will be flowing in opposite direction. So in this way you have to calculate the responding current for different value of weights. Okay, over here we are using 10 mg, 20 mg, 30 mg and 50 mg. These are the readings of this company. So they have used 50, 10 and 150 mg. But practically in this our session we are using 10 mg, 20 mg, 30 mg and 50 mg. And we are giving the corresponding current with respect to that and finding out the deflections over here. Okay, after doing that you have to find out the value of average current, that is by changing the polarity. First you have to do with this polarity, then you have to change the polarity so that you will get two values of current. You will get two values of current and you have to take the average current of that. Okay, you have to take I square, you have to take F by I square, then you will take the mean of it, or you can also take the slope of that and you can find out the average. And you have to find out this value Ka, this you have to find out D0 A by 2D, and at last you will get mu0 by substituting in this formula. You will get mu0. It's near about 4π × 10⁻⁷. If you have near about answer, then it will be correct one. Okay, we have also, remember this is in MKS system, so you have to take the conversion of this CGS to MKS systems from this weight also. So force also F is equals to m into g, that has to converted into mks. Okay, so this is all about the permeability, finding out the permeability using this setup. Okay, we will also upload the synopsis on Moodle, so please try to go through this synopsis and try to study this practical. Okay, thank you.